the only way I can guide you is by knowing what you're seeing. So tell me what it is that is going through your mind's eye.
Pyramids.
Pyramids. Mm-hmm. How many do you see?
There's one big one.
One big one. Mm-hmm. How far away are you from the pyramid?
Close.
Hmm?
Very close.
Very close. Mm-hmm. Look down on the ground. Can you see if you can see any feet down there? Do you feel like you have a body there?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Look down at the ground. Look at your feet. Are you wearing anything on your feet?
No.
Are you barefooted?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Do you feel that those are male or female feet?
Male.
Male. Mm-hmm. So as you acclimate yourself to that male body, see if you can sense something else of the appearance of your body there. You may want to see what you're wearing.
I have dark skin.
Dark skin? Mm-hmm. Can you tell what your features are like?
Curly hair.
Mm-hmm. Curly hair.
Brown eyes.
Brown eyes. Mm-hmm. What are you wearing?
Rags.
Rags. Mm-hmm. Any particular color?
Dirty.
Dirty rags. Mm-hmm. How old do you feel there?
Young man.
A young man. A teenager, 20s?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. What else do you feel about this young man? How do you feel?
Hurt.
Hurt? Mm-hmm. What's going on?
I think he's a slave.
Mm-hmm. You're a slave? Mm-hmm. Look around you and see if you see anybody else.
A lot of people.
A lot of people. Mm-hmm. Now you feel that you're a slave. Do you feel that your hands or feet are free, or are they enslaved? You're free.
No shackles.
No shackles. But you know that you're not free as a man. Okay.
I have a job.
You have a job. Tell me what that job is.
Pushing rocks.
Pushing rocks? Mm-hmm.
Carrying things.
Carrying things.
Building.
Building. Mm-hmm. You're building the pyramids. How many others are there with you?
A lot of people.
Are they all slaves too?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Are they all wearing the same thing?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Not much clothes.
Not much clothes.
There's families too.
The whole family's there. With children also.
There's children, there's women.
Women.
Mostly men.
Mostly men. Look at your statue. Are you a big man or a small man?
Thin, very thin.
Very thin. Mm-hmm.
Not that tall.
Not that tall. Take a look around you and see if you could find who is your leader.
Dark man.
He's a dark man.
Mm-hmm. Big man.
A big man.
Strong.
Big and strong.
Tall.
Tall. How tall would you think he is? Is he like a normal sized man or is he taller than that?
Six something.
Six something? Mm-hmm. And what is he wearing?
Gold.
Gold? Mm-hmm.
I can't describe it.
You can't describe it? Is he wearing some type of a uniform?
Looks like a king.
He looks like a king? Mm-hmm. Does he have robes?
No.
No? But you say he has gold. Mm-hmm. Is this gold? Something in his
wrists.
In his wrists, okay.
Neck.
In his neck.
Head.
In his neck.
Mm-hmm. In his head.
Mm-hmm.
Stones.
Stones.
Rubies.
Rubies. Mm-hmm. In the gold. Mm-hmm. What does his features look like? Are they like yours? Does he look different?
A little different.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Alright, I want you to leave that scene now. Leave that scene behind. And we're going to drift and float to another time. Another time in that same lifetime when something is happening. We're going forward. Tell me what's going on.
Family.
Mm-hmm. What do you see?
Wife, children.
Wife and children. Mm-hmm. How many children are there?
Two.
Two. Mm-hmm. Are they male or female? About how old are they?
Small.
Small? Mm-hmm. Tell me where it is that you are.
Home.
Home. Mm-hmm. So describe your home for me. What does it look like?
It's hard to describe.
Mm-hmm.
Mud.
Mud? Mm-hmm.
Walls.
Mud walls? Like a cave. Mm-hmm.
Weird.
Weird. Let's go outside of this home and see what it looks like from the outside. How do you get outside?
It is a cave.
It is a cave. You live inside of a cave?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Are you by yourself in there with your family or are there others with you?
Just us.
Just you. Mm-hmm. You're hiding. What's happened? Did you run away?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Tell me what happened.
Don't want to be a slave.
You don't want to be a slave. So did you take your family away from there?
Yes.
Okay. Are they looking for you?
Yes.
Okay. How are you feeling?
Worried.
Mm-hmm.
Scared. Protective.
You're very protective of your family?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So let's see what happens next. I want you to fast forward and tell me what happens. They found you. Tell me who found you.
His army.
The army?
His army.
His army? Mm-hmm. How many are there? What is it? It's a group of them? Mm-hmm. 5, 6 more?
20
of them. Mm-hmm. And they were looking for you? So what happens now? Tell me everything that happens.
Whips.
Whips? Mm-hmm. Do they whip you?
They beat me.
They beat you?
They whip me.
Mm-hmm. What happens with your family?
You hurt my wife.
What is it?
You hurt my wife.
They hurt your wife? Mm-hmm. What did they do to her?
They raped
her?
They beat her.
What happened to your children?
They
took the kids.
We can't have our kids.
You can't have your kids. So what happened to you?
They killed me.
They killed you. All right. So whatever has happened has already happened. You're on the other side of it. There's no more pain. As you look back on that life, you can see the lesson and the purpose. Every life has a lesson. Every life has a purpose. As you look back on that life, what was the theme of it? What was the purpose of that life?
My family.
Your family.
Mm-hmm.
That's all you had. Mm-hmm. And what happened? You weren't able to protect them. So how are you feeling?
I failed.
You failed. So the lesson was to protect your family and you couldn't do it. Mm-hmm. So now that you're in spirit, I want you to continue on your path and tell me what happens next. Where do you go?
Back to the light.
You go back to the light. Okay, now that you're in the light, you'll be able to see all of the different lifetimes that you've had. And I want you to focus on the lifetime of a woman named Jackie. And tell me what it is that's happening in her lifetime now that has been influenced by your lifetime? What is she picking up from you? What is it?
Pain.
Pain? Mm-hmm. What kind of pain?
Physical and emotional.
Physical and emotional. Okay. So all of the pain that she's feeling is from that lifetime?
She has her own.
She has her own. Mm-hmm. But she's picking up some of yours? Okay, so why don't we release that now? I want you to see that that was one lifetime that you lived, and that you were able to come back again and try all over again. Do you see that?
Yes.
So even though you feel that you failed, but you actually took your family and you did a very heroic thing. Do you see how heroic it was for you to make that decision and leave and not be enslaved anymore?
I tried.
Mm-hmm. You made a decision, a very important one. Do you see that you did that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So now Jackie can see that all she has to do is make decisions, like you did.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. That when you feel enslaved by people or by circumstances, that family comes first, and that you were able to take them out of that that enslavement, even though it was for a little while. But you made a decision, didn't you? So go ahead and tell Jackie about that and tell her how she can do the same thing.
Make decisions.
Mm-hmm.
Don't be scared.
Don't be scared. You don't need to be a slave to anybody, do you?
Not anymore.
Not anymore. Mm-hmm. So you could see that that life was meant for you to learn that no matter what circumstances you find yourself in, all you have to do is make a decision to change it. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And even though the family didn't last very long, but you made that decision. And rather than dying as a slave, you died as someone free.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Wonderful. Thank you very much for your time. May the light of the universe accompany you. And now I'm going to ask you to drift and float again to another time and another place. We're drifting and floating to another lifetime where there's information that will help you in the very best way that we can help you. Drifting and floating, floating and drifting. Be there now. What do you see? What do you see? A little girl. Mm-hmm. Tell me about this little girl. How old is she?
I'm a little girl.
Mm-hmm. I'm a little girl. Mm-hmm. How old are you there?
Six.
Six? Mm-hmm. Six or seven. So tell me where it is that you are.
America.
Mm-hmm. America? Mm-hmm.
Home.
Home? Mm-hmm. So tell me about your home. What does it look like? It's old fashioned.
I live with my father.
You what?
I live with my father.
You live with your father?
He hurts me.
It hurts? He hurts you? Tell me how he hurts you.
He doesn't love me.
He doesn't love you.
He touches me.
He touches you? How do you feel about it when he touches you?
Scared.
What happened to your mommy? Okay. Look down at yourself. What is it that you're wearing?
A dress.
How long is this dress?
Knees.
To your knees? Okay.
Curly hair.
What color is it?
Blonde.
And what do they call you there?
Lucy.
So, Lucy, you say you live with your father. Is this your real father? And what else do you need to do for your father?
Clean.
You have to clean for him? That's a lot for a little girl to do. What happens if you don't clean?
The belt. I get the belt.
You get the belt. That must be very scary, Lucy. Does he give you the belt a lot?
Yeah.
Do you go to school?
No.
You stay home?
Yes.
Do you have any brothers or sisters?
No.
You just live with your father?
By myself.
You live by yourself?
When he goes to work.
When he goes to work, you're by yourself? Do you have to do anything else besides clean?
I take care of myself.
You take care of yourself. Okay. Do you have to cook too? You don't know how?
Too small.
Okay, Lucy. Lucy, we're going to drift and float to another time, another place. You're going in the same lifetime, and now you're sitting down and having something to eat. It's time for a meal. And tell me what you're eating.
A sandwich.
And milk. Who's with you there?
Dad's sister?
Does she take care of you?
Sometimes.
How old are you now, Lucy?
11.
11? How do you feel now living there? A little better? What's happened? What's changed?
She helps take care of me.
She helps take care of you? Does she live with you?
She loves me.
She loves you? Does your daddy love you? No, but she does.
She protects me.
She protects you? Does your daddy still touch you? Not as much. Okay, that's good. That's good. Okay, Lucy, we're gonna drift to another time when you're older now. We're drifting and floating to another time, another place. You're older now. Tell me where you are. You're at your house.
Mm-hmm. I'm married.
You're married. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
How old are you?
17.
17. Mm-hmm. Who are you married to? What does he look like?
Handsome.
He's handsome. Mm-hmm.
He's tall.
Tall. How do you feel about him?
I love him.
You love him. Mm-hmm. So tell me more about your husband.
He has a temper too.
He has a temper too? Mm-hmm. So what happens?
We have children.
You have children. How many children do you have?
We have a child.
A child. Mm-hmm.
A girl.
A girl. He's what?
He's a good dad.
He's a good dad. Mm-hmm. Are you happy in your marriage?
I think there's other women.
You think there's other women? Mm-hmm. Think he's cheating on you?
But I don't stop him.
But you don't stop him. Why don't you stop him, Lucy? Takes care of you. Okay. All right. We're gonna leave that scene behind. Let's leave that scene behind, and now you're gonna get older now. You're going ahead in time and space to a very important time when something's happening. What's going on?
She's getting married now.
Your daughter is getting married?
Mm-hmm.
And she's happy. How are you feeling?
Peaceful.
Mm-hmm.
He died.
He died. So you're by yourself?
Yes.
How do you feel by yourself?
Peaceful.
Peaceful. Mm-hmm. How old are you, Lucy?
30. Daughter
looks happy?
Yeah.
Okay.
She takes care of me now.
Oh, she takes care of you now.
And her family.
And her family. So you feel at peace. Very good. Alright, so let's go now to when you're almost ready to die, Lucy. You're much older now. Tell me what's happening. You're sleeping?
I was in bed.
You were in bed? Mm-hmm. And what happened?
Faded.
You just faded away. Okay, Lucy, so whatever has happened has already happened. You're on the other side now, and you can look back at that entire life and see what the lesson and the purpose was of that life. What was the purpose of that lifetime? Take care of yourself. Do you feel that you did a good job of that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And what did you need to learn from that?
Forgiving yourself.
Forgiving yourself? Mm-hmm. So, Lucy, as you look at that lifetime, you can see that there are similarities to another aspect of you called Jackie. As you look down at Jackie's life, what parts of her life are being influenced by your lifetime? Hmm? The men.
Mm-hmm.
So what happened in your lifetime that's affecting her with men? The father.
Mm-hmm.
Is it the same father that you had?
No.
No? But he's acting the same?
No.
No? Tell me what it is that she needs to learn from yours, or what she's getting from yours. What is it?
The men she chooses.
The men she chooses?
Like her father, like her husband.
Like her father and like her husband.
Doesn't your husband.
Mm-hmm. So what advice would you like to give Jackie about men?
Choose wisely.
Choose wisely. Mm-hmm. Very good. Would you be able to advise her from where you are, since you are an aspect of hers?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Very good. Is there anything that we need to help you with? Or did you go to the light? Mm-hmm. Very good. Well, Lucy, thank you very much for the time that you've been with us. I really appreciate it. And I also would like to thank all of the other entities that we were speaking to. They will find peace. They will find what they're supposed to find. We're leaving them there to continue on their journey. Do I have permission to ask questions?
Yes.
Thank you. I know that the higher self could have brought forth many different lifetimes for Jackie to see today. And you chose to bring forward the life of a slave working on the pyramids. Why did you show her that life? It's the same feeling that she had?
Trapped.
She feels trapped? You could speak louder, because she would like to hear this herself. So she feels trapped also?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Pain.
What's the pain all about?
Not in control.
Not in control. Mm-hmm. Is the pain that she's feeling in her body now because of that lifetime?
Partially.
Well, now that Jackie knows that that pain is associated with that lifetime, can we go ahead and cut those ties so that she doesn't feel that pain anymore? She doesn't need it now.
Yeah.
Let's cut those. Let's leave that, all that discomfort, to dissipate away and have her connect only with this lifetime right now. We don't need that anymore. She's already seen what caused the pain, and it was the enslavement. Is there anything else from that lifetime that she's carrying over? I also chose to show her a lifetime of little Lucy that was being abused by her father. Why did you show her that lifetime?
Similarities.
What is it?
Similarities.
Similarities. Mm-hmm. Is she carrying any pain from that lifetime? What's that?
Pain from her father.
Mm-hmm.
Not having a
Not having a father. Mm-hmm. So what advice would you like to give her about that?
You have a father.
Mm-hmm. You have a father. Mm-hmm.
He loves you.
He loves you. Mm-hmm. He's just difficult.
He won't hurt you.
He won't hurt you. So when she is with her father, has been with all these years, was she feeling that same fear from Lucy's life, that he was going to hurt her physically?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So we don't need that anymore. We know that that came from that pain. It's not the same body. It's not the same soul. Can we release that now?
Thank you very much.
Is there anything else that you would like to tell her about these lives?
You found happiness.
Mm-hmm. You found happiness?
You can find it again.
You can find it again. Mm-hmm. Just like Lucy did? Mm-hmm. She found peace at the end, didn't she?
Yes.
She had a daughter. Mm-hmm. Is there anybody from any of these lifetimes that are in her life now?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Who are they?
Mother.
Her mother.
Mm-hmm. Her daughter before.
Was her daughter before?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So they have a connection there. So she protected her daughter, and now she's protecting her mother?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Is there anybody else there? Does she have any connection with her, any of her husband or her wife from that time?
No.
No, okay. So the most important is the mother. Has her mother been in her lifetime before?
Yes.
Okay, so they're always going around together.
Sister.
As sisters, mm-hmm. Is there any other lifetime that you would like to show her at this time before we move forward? Or were those two enough?
That's fine.
That's fine, okay. Jackie said that she wants to meet her spirit guides and they say thank you. Who are they? Her Grandma Rosa is always watching?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Is she a spirit guide now, or is she just an ancestor that's concerned about her?
Concerned.
Mm-hmm. Did Rosa go to the light after she passed?
Not yet.
Not yet. Mm-hmm. So does Rosa hang out at the house a lot?
Sometimes.
Sometimes. Would Rosa like to go to the light now? Would you ask her if we can assist her?
Not ready.
She's not ready. Okay. Is there anything that Rosa would like to tell her granddaughter today? Mm-hmm. I love you.
Proud of you.
I'm proud of you.
Mm-hmm. Watch over your mom.
Watch over your mom. Is that why Rosa hasn't gone to the light yet? She's concerned about her daughter?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. the thing is that Rosa would be able to help her better in the light, rather than just being there in the house. Okay. So Rosa, I'd like you to look up into the above you, and you should be able to see the light above you. Take a look and see if you see it.
Yes.
Okay. All you have to do, Rosa, is go up to that light and be there. And I'm going to ask Archangel Michael to help you. Tell me when you've gone to the light. In the light. Okay, Rosa. So now that you're in the light, you'll be able to help your granddaughter and your daughter from that position. You'll be able to rest, go to school, learn how to do more guidance, and you can help them anytime you wish from the light. How does it feel to be in the light?
Wonderful.
Wonderful. Okay. We'll say something to your granddaughter before you leave.
I love you very much.
Thank you very much. Okay. Thank you very much, Rosa. May the light of the universe accompany you. Many blessings to you. So let me speak with the higher self again. We see that Rosa was helping her, but I know that Jackie has spirit guides.
Yes.
Who are they in particular? How many does she have?
Many.
Many? Mm-hmm. Is there anyone in particular that helps her a lot? Two of them. Mm-hmm.
Indian.
They're Indian?
One.
One is an Indian? Mm-hmm.
Gypsy.
A gypsy. Mm-hmm. So when you say Indian, are you talking about a Native American or Indian from India?
Native American.
Native American? Mm-hmm. Is it a male or female?
Male.
Mm-hmm.
Big.
A big man.
Strong.
Mm-hmm.
Loving.
And heavy?
Loving.
And the other one is a gypsy?
Yes.
Is this a woman or a man?
Woman.
A woman.
Beautiful.
Beautiful. Do they have names?
Tahoe.
No?
Tahoe.
Tahoe?
Mm-hmm.
And what roles do they play in her life?
Protection.
Well, I know that Jackie wanted to say thank you for that.
Our job.
And that's your job. Very good. You're doing a good job with her.
Thank you.
How many past lives has she had?
Numerous.
What is it? Hundreds?
Numerous.
Okay. Any examples of them besides those two that you showed us?
A maid.
Mm-hmm. Is that past life affecting her also?
No.
Okay. What's her true purpose or gift?
Communicating.
Mm-hmm. In any particular way?
Many ways.
Many ways. Is she doing that now?
No.
How would you like her to progress with that?
Writing.
Writing?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. meeting, talking and meeting people?
She has to meet new people.
Meet new people. Is this like in her job or something else?
No.
No. How should she get out there in the world? What is it?
Videos.
Videos. She should produce videos?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. In any particular way or theme?
Beliefs.
Her beliefs. Okay. That sounds good.
Passion.
Her passion. Mm-hmm.
She wants to write.
She wants to write. Okay, so she should be doing videos about that?
Yes.
Okay, terrific. She said that she was interested in writing, and she wanted to know what direction. Is that about the beliefs and passions?
Yes.
Okay. Well, I know that she was doing a lot of research on the secret societies and things like that. Is that something that she should continue to pursue, or is she behind that now?
Move on.
Okay. So nothing about that. Keep it positive?
Yes.
Okay. Terrific. She has questions about how to become more spiritual. How can she do that?
Meditate.
But she finds that boring.
No?
She kind of moved away from it?
Distraction.
So how would you get her to meditate again?
She has to find time for herself.
Okay, she's not finding time?
Make time.
Okay, make time and find time. Mm-hmm. Very good. And then she'll become more spiritual when she connects?
Forgive yourself.
Forgive yourself, okay. So this would help her with her meditation?
Yes.
Okay. What is it that she needs to forgive?
She's hurt others.
Mm-hmm.
Accidentally.
Accidentally? Mm-hmm. And she hasn't forgiven herself?
She
struggles with that. Okay. Do we need to do a forgiveness exercise on that?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. All right, so allow me to do that for her. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my hand on your chest. And when I do, I want you to give me all of the feelings that you have, remorse, resentment, anything, anybody who's ever hurt you and that you've hurt. Give that all to me, because that's a lot of baggage to be carrying with you. Pull all of that out from all of your cells in your body. Today we start brand new with a clean slate. Give me all of those feelings that you have. We're going to send them off to the universe for healing. And tell me when you've emptied everything out. Take that off and send it off to the universe for healing. Now, in that space that you have left there, what would you like to fill it with? Lots of love. Lots of love for yourself. What else?
Gratitude.
Gratitude. Let's put lots of gratitude in there. Anything else? A lot of self-worth. And let's put some self-confidence in there, too. Let's seal that. Mm-hmm. You good? Wonderful. All right, let me speak with your higher self again. So tell me how she's doing now.
Better.
Very good. So as she allows that confidence and self-love and value in herself grow, She'll feel herself filling more and more with joy and peace.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Because we all know that sometimes people hurt us and we hurt others, and it's forgiveness that's most important. So tell her, how can she find true happiness?
Self-worth.
Okay.
Appreciate life.
Appreciate life. Mm-hmm. Is she doing that now?
No.
No. Okay, so we're going to take some baby steps first. Start appreciating things about her life so that she can understand how worthy she is. Okay, that's good. She says that she lacks a lot of confidence and she wants to learn to love herself 100%. What else would you like to tell her? You're beautiful the way you are.
Love yourself.
Love yourself. Mm-hmm. Beautiful. Anything else?
Self-worth.
Self-worth. Mm-hmm. Loving yourself.
Respect yourself.
Respect yourself.
Stand up for yourself.
Stand up for yourself. Very good. She said that she's had a lot of difficulties in love. She's had a history of being abused by people in her life, men in her life. Mm-hmm. You have found what?
She allowed it.
Oh, she allowed it. Okay. So what would you like to tell her about that? She's afraid of being alone.
There's nothing to be afraid of.
Nothing to be afraid of.
You're at your best when you're alone.
Mm-hmm. You're at your best when you're alone. So she needs to allow herself to be alone so that she can be creative and meditate.
Yes.
And love herself more.
Yes.
Okay. And set boundaries.
She needs boundaries.
She needs boundaries. Mm-hmm. Very good. Well, she's currently in a relationship. And she wants to know, what's the purpose of having this man in her life? Is this a mistake?
No mistakes.
No mistakes. What's she learning from this?
Patience.
Patience. Mm-hmm. Should she move on or should she stay with him?
She knows.
She knows. Okay. So you're not going to tell her? Move on. Okay. Respect herself, right?
Yes.
Okay, she doesn't need to be abused by anyone.
You deserve better.
You deserve better. She does. Well, she could see how wonderful she felt when her daughter was getting married in that lifetime. She was happy. Is her body able to have children in this lifetime? When the time is right. Well, what was the reason for that miscarriage?
Time was not right.
It wasn't right. Was it a boy or a girl that she miscarried?
A girl.
A girl. Is this girl in her life now? Does she look over her?
Moved on.
She moved on? Okay. So she's no longer in her life?
No.
Okay, we don't need to meet her then.
No.
Okay. Very good. She wants to be able to resolve the karma that she's had with her sister. How can she help her sister overcome her addictions?
All she can do is love her.
All she can do is love her. From afar?
She's been distant.
She's been tested?
She's been distant.
Oh, she has been distant. Okay.
Reunite.
Does she need to reunite her?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And how does she do that?
Spend time with her.
Spend time with her.
Mm-hmm. She is healing.
She is healing?
Yes.
Okay. Does she have karma with her sister? No. Okay. So there's nothing there to learn. She just needs to love her.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And you already talked about her father. How can she change the situation with him?
Spend time with him.
Spend time with him?
Stop distancing yourself.
Stop distancing yourself? Mm-hmm. Because right now there's a lack of affection and communication.
Give the affection you want.
Give the affection that you want? Mm-hmm. Will he accept it?
Yes.
Okay, terrific. How could you bring the whole family together? She can't.
It's not her job.
Not your job. Okay.
Out of her hands.
Out of her hands. Okay.
Just love them.
Just love them. What about her nephew?
Take care of him.
Take care of him? Mm-hmm. Like a second mother?
Yes.
Okay. Terrific. Is her nephew anybody from her previous life?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Who was he?
Her son.
Her son? Mm-hmm. Was it in any lifetime that we saw? No, from a different lifetime. So she naturally is attracted to him for that reason? Did he seek her out?
Yes.
Okay. So that's why he's in that lifetime, to be with her? Not with his own mother?
No.
Okay. What was the reason for him choosing the mother that he chose?
Bring her love.
Bring her love. Okay. And he's going to do that?
Yes.
Okay. Terrific. Let's talk about her job. She's not very happy where she is right now. How can she apply her gift into her career?
Leave.
Leave? Okay. Is there a job waiting for her somewhere?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Who's helping her find this job? The universe, okay. So she has to believe in that? Because we don't want her just out of a job. We want her to find a job first.
She has to make up her mind.
Make up her mind? Okay. So when she sets the intention out there to leave?
It will happen.
It will happen. So the same as boundary, setting boundaries, she has to set intentions also.
Yes.
Okay. Good. So her homework for after this is to set that intention.
Yes.
Okay, terrific. She says that since she was a child, she has a dream of becoming a hypnotherapist. And she needs help. She wants to know where to begin. She wants to know if this is her calling in life.
Yes.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. This is the beginning.
This is the beginning?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What would you like to tell her about this?
Indulge.
Indulge? Mm-hmm.
Do research.
Do research. Mm-hmm. Follow your dreams. So when she sets her intention to follow her dreams, the universe will oblige?
Yes.
Okay. And we want her to make sure that she uses a discount. Very good. Mm-hmm. All right, let's see what else we have here. She says that when she's always used to be a expert lucid dreamer, but now she's losing her ability to control her dreams or remember them. What's going on there?
She needs to sleep at peace.
Sleep at peace. What's happening right now?
Too much on her mind.
Mm-hmm.
Distractions. Not enough sleep.
Mm-hmm. What she's eating also?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What is she eating that she shouldn't be eating?
What she's not eating.
What she's not eating? What do you recommend she eat more of?
What she doesn't like.
More vegetables?
Yes.
And fruits?
Greens.
Greens, okay. Well, I know she doesn't like to eat them. Well, how would you recommend that she consume these things? Juices or what?
Juicing.
Mm-hmm.
Taste buds will change.
The taste buds will change when she starts juicing?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And then she'll like them more?
Yes.
So we need to clean out her system.
Yes.
Okay. So who can I call in to help her with that? We need some heavy-duty spiritual help here. How can we get her to change? Someone who'll whisper in her ears about eating her vegetables.
She has to decide.
She has to decide.
It's all up to her.
It's all up to her. So it's the same thing, really. It's making the decision.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Would this decision help with the weight issues?
Of course.
Of course. So we need to get the food changed. What's going on with all her health issues? Let's do a body scan on her and see what you find in her body.
Stomach.
What's going on with her stomach?
Acid.
Mm-hmm. Where's that coming from?
The food she eats.
So her stomach is complaining?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Toxics.
Toxic. What would the stomach prefer to be eating?
Organic.
Organic.
Mm-hmm. Fresh.
So no processed food?
Fresh fruits and vegetables.
Fresh fruits and any particular kind or just the one she likes?
Colors.
Colors.
More
so
color better.
So make sure that her plate is colorful.
Yes.
Okay. What happened with her vision?
Her smoking?
Yes. Mm-hmm. So is it causing her to lose her vision? What's going on with that?
She coughs.
She coughs?
Mm-hmm. Causes pressure in the brain.
Causes pressure in the brain?
That's how the brain releases pressure.
Ah, that's how the brain releases pressure.
To clench.
Mm-hmm.
She'll be fine.
She'll be fine. Okay, so what would you recommend about her smoking?
Slow down.
Slow down? Okay.
Stop smoking.
And stop smoking? Can we get you to clear her lungs out while we're here? So that we can get rid of that addiction.
She realizes that?
What does she realize?
She relies on it.
She relies on it. Mm-hmm. Is it an addiction?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So how can we remove that addiction? What is it?
She has to be with nature.
She has to be with nature. Okay, so get some pure oxygen?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Where would you recommend that she go? To the beach or to the forest?
Both.
Okay. And while she's in nature, can we get some of the nature spirits to help her with that?
Always.
Always. Okay. So I'd like to put in a special request for nature spirits to help her and her addiction.
Yes.
So that she doesn't, they could clear her lungs out, connect her to Mother Earth, so that we don't have these issues anymore. So that she doesn't have to rely on the smoking.
She uses it as a crutch.
She uses it as a crutch. Mm-hmm.
You don't. Me? Yeah.
So all she has to do is get to a higher frequency?
Yes.
Okay. Could you help her with that?
Yes.
Okay, she's going to be a light worker. We don't need her body polluted.
Yes.
With toxins. Would you look at the rest of her body? She says she was having some aches and pains. Some discomfort.
Back.
Her back. What's going on with her back?
Herniated disc.
Herniated disc?
Mm-hmm.
What caused that?
Her weight.
Her weight. Mm-hmm. Well, that would be a very motivating factor to lose some weight and get some vegetables.
Therapy.
Therapy. What kind of therapy does she need?
Physical.
Physical therapy? Mm-hmm.
Yoga.
Yoga.
Stretch. Connect with the body.
Connect with the body? Mm-hmm. What else? That's all she needs. Can I get one of the angels that helps her to motivate her to find the right place to exercise so that she's happy there?
Yes.
Okay, so let me ask for guidance on that. We want to focus on her skin now. She says she has a rare skin disease that causes her to break out in a rash. What's going on with her, with that large organ of hers, her body, the skin?
It's the toxics.
It's toxic. Mm-hmm. What's causing?
Your body's polluted.
The body is polluted. Mm-hmm.
It's the defense mechanism.
The defense mechanism? How has she been polluting her body?
The food.
The food, okay.
Hatred.
What is it?
Hatred.
Hatred.
Negative.
negativity. Mm-hmm. All of that has polluted her body.
Yes.
Okay. So what would you like to tell her about that? It's not a disease at all, is it?
You have to love yourself.
Love yourself. Mm-hmm. Is that why the pain is unbearable?
It's a reminder.
It's a reminder. Okay. You have to love yourself. So when she begins loving herself, this condition will disappear?
Yes.
Okay, good. What about that spot that she had above her breast, that birthmark? What's that from? That's a past life. What happened there?
Shot.
She was shot. That's what I thought. Was she shot with some sort of a musket or something?
Up close.
Up close. Mm-hmm. So what is that reminding her of? Why did she choose to come into that life with this birthmark?
Protect yourself.
Protect yourself. Mm-hmm. Was she a man or a woman in that lifetime?
Man.
A man. Mm-hmm. So what does he need her to protect herself from? Negativity. Now I know that birthmark is affecting her physically. It's a physical reminder. But is there also something attached to that she's holding on to? Some pain from that life that we need to heal? Mm-hmm.
No trust.
Mm-hmm. There's no trust? Okay. Can we connect with that man now from that past life? So that we can heal that lifetime. Allow me to connect with that lifetime and tell me what happened.
Yes.
Okay. Take a deep breath and let's travel through time and space and find yourself in that lifetime with the man who was shot at close range. Tell me where he is.
Italy.
Mm-hmm. All right. Acclimate yourself to be there. Be there now. And tell me where you are. Tell me what you look like.
Tall.
Mm-hmm.
Light skin.
Light skin. Brown hair.
Slick.
Slick?
Slick hair.
Slick hair. Mm-hmm.
I look like a mobster.
Mm-hmm. You look like a mobster.
Like a gangster.
Like a gangster. Uh-huh.
That's in the suit.
Mm-hmm. What year do you feel that you're in?
1920.
Okay. So tell me what's happening there. Where are you?
Bar.
A bar. Mm-hmm.
Fight.
There's a fight. Mm-hmm.
Money.
There's money involved.
Drugs.
Drugs.
Alcohol.
And alcohol. What is it that you're doing there? Why is there a fight? Selling drugs?
Many things.
many things.
It's a battle of territory.
Oh, this was your territory? Mm-hmm. So who was it that you're going against?
Competition.
Mm-hmm. They're trying to come into your territory. Mm-hmm. So what happens next?
It's quick.
It's quick. Where are you?
On the street.
On the street? Mm-hmm.
I've been shot.
You've been shot. Who shot you? So now, whatever has happened has already happened. You're on the other side of it now. You can look back at that lifetime and tell me what was going on in that lifetime. What is it?
A lot of deaths. A lot of people died.
A lot of people died because of you? Mm-hmm. Did you kill a lot of people?
Us. I did what I was told.
You did what you were told.
Mm-hmm. I needed the money.
You needed the money. Were you hired to kill people? Mm-hmm.
We all did what we were told.
You all did what you were told. You had someone who told you what to do?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So now that you're on the other side of it, how do you feel about all this killing?
I need to be forgiven.
Mm-hmm. All right. So what is it that, what name did they call you in that lifetime? What is it?
Bobby.
Bobby. Okay, Bobby, how old were you when you died?
36.
And you were Italian?
Yes.
Okay, so Bobby, before you, you need to heal from all of this. What I'm going to do, Bobby, is put my hand on your chest. And I want you to give me all of the pain that you've been suffering because of what you've done in that lifetime.
I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm. I want you to see all the people that you killed. And I want you to ask for forgiveness of all of those souls and tell them how you feel. I want you to unload it on me. And give it all to me. Unload it all, Bobby. Tell me when it's done. When you have asked for forgiveness of all those souls that you've killed.
It's done.
All right. I'm going to take all that from you, Bobby, and send it up to the universe to be healed. Now, Bobby, you know now that since you are a soul, you know that you could not have killed any of those people. They were just bodies, and they went to the light too. And now that you have asked for forgiveness, you are now light. And now, in the place of all of that pain that you felt, I want you to tell me what it is that you would like me to replace in that space. What would you like to put there?
Peace.
So let's put all of that peace in there and seal it. Anything else, Bobby?
Forgiveness.
Lots of forgiveness. Mm-hmm. Love and lots of love. And Bobby, now that you are in the light, You felt all that forgiveness. How do you feel? So you know now that you do not need to show yourself with this birthmark anymore. That was a reminder. And let me ask you something, Bobby. Did you go to the light, or were you attached to this woman?
Attached.
Mm-hmm. Would you like her to forgive you for being attached to her?
Yes.
Okay, so let me ask her. Jackie, do you see that this Bobby was attached to you and was showing himself as a birthmark?
Yes.
Okay, would you like to send him to you, the light?
Yes.
Do you forgive him for causing that?
Yes.
Okay, let me speak with him. Bobby, do you feel the forgiveness from Jackie?
Yes.
Okay. What else did you cause her? What other physical symptoms did you cause her besides the birthmark?
Anger.
Anger. Mm-hmm. Has it been your anger that she's been feeling all of this time?
Mostly.
Mm-hmm. What else have you caused her? Ego. Mm-hmm. So what would you like to tell her about that? About causing her all this anger?
Let it go.
Let it go. Okay, Bobby. Are you ready to go to the light now?
Yes.
Okay. So, Bobby, I'm going to ask my angels to come and surround you to escort you into the light. I want you to go up, up, up through her crown, right here. I want you to find your way up to her crown, and I want you to take all of the influence that you have in her body with you. I want you to cut all the cords, disconnect from her, from every cell in her body where you've inhabited. Pull them out. And I want Jackie to do the same from your end. I want you to pull out those cords and cut them. Allow Bobby to leave. Pull everything out where he was. Every single spot that he was inhabiting, I want you to pull it out and give it to him. And Bobby, I want you to tell me when you see the angels. They're surrounding you now, ready to escort you into the light. And as you go up into the light, you will see Archangel Michael reaching his hand out to you. Grab his hand and go into the light. You've been forgiven, and now you'll be able to go to school. You will not be punished at all. You'll be received with love. And once you go to school and rest, you'll be able to come back as a new spirit. You're welcome, Bobby. May the light of the universe accompany you. And now I would like Archangel Raphael to flood her body with a beautiful light to seal her. Seal her entire body with light. And focus on the area where Bobby was residing and clear that out. And when you're done, let me speak with the higher self again.
Yes.
Thank you very much. She asked about her anger, and I know that she removed some of the anger through Bobby. Is there anybody else that's lingering there that's causing her anger? Scan her body for any shadows that may be lingering. Mm-hmm. Where is the shadow? In your heart. Okay, so I'm going to take my hand and put it over your heart and bring the energy up and speak with it. Express yourself, brother. How long have you been there with Jackie?
A long time.
A long time. How old was she when you where it became attached to her? A teenager. What were the circumstances around this? What made her so vulnerable?
Same frequency.
The same frequency. Was she feeling angry or depressed?
Sad.
Mm-hmm. Are you male or female energy?
Female.
What is your name, mate? What may I call you?
Elizabeth.
Elizabeth, what year is it for you?
1849.
Mm-hmm. Elizabeth, recall when you had a body. And where was it that you were living? Do you remember? In England.
Mm-hmm.
And how is it that you lost your body? How did you die?
I killed myself.
You killed yourself.
Mm-hmm.
How old were you, Elizabeth?
20s.
That's a very young age to kill yourself. Why did you kill yourself?
Broken heart.
A broken heart. Did someone hurt you?
I lost someone.
Who did you lose? Who did you lose? Your love.
Mm-hmm.
How did he pass? In the war. They killed him? In the war? And you couldn't stand being by yourself? Mm-hmm. Were you very angry or very sad?
Both.
Mm-hmm. So Elizabeth, how is it that you found Jackie?
The mirror.
Through the mirror. Did she call you?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. And you found her through that. Were you happy to find her?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What was it for you that, what did you get out of it by being attached to her?
You felt the same pain.
You felt the same thing. And you have been traveling a long time, big time and space. Elizabeth, when you passed, when you killed yourself, how was it that you did it?
Slit my wrists.
You slit your wrists. Mm-hmm. Did you give Jackie the same ideas?
I gave her the thoughts.
The thoughts. Do you think that was fair for you to do that to her?
It's not on purpose.
Not on purpose. Elizabeth, would you like to be forgiven for all of those thoughts that you gave her?
Yes.
All right, let me speak with Jackie. Jackie, do you see that this young woman who killed herself has been with you all this time?
Yeah.
What would you like to tell her? You forgive her for that. You called her in, not knowing.
She drives me crazy.
Mm-hmm, that she drives you crazy. Okay. So let's let her go with love so that she can find peace. Let me speak with Elizabeth. Elizabeth, you see that Jackie has forgiven you? Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Would you tell Jackie what other things you made her feel all this time?
Lonely.
Mm-hmm. Is that because you missed your love?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. What else?
Anger.
Anger. Mm-hmm. Were you the one that she calls the dark passenger?
I am what I am.
Mm-hmm. You are what you are. What else did you make her feel? Any discomfort in her body? Pain in the heart. Mm-hmm. Are you ready to release all of that pain, Elizabeth? Because we need to send you to the light where you'll find your love there. Are you ready to see him again? Okay, because he's been there all the time waiting for you. But before you go, you need to release all of that pain. Would you allow me to do that for you? All right, I'm going to put my hand on your chest, Elizabeth, and I want you to unload all of that pain that you had, all of that pain, all of that anger, all of that feeling of loneliness. Pull it out of all of the cells in her body. We're going to take that away from you so that you can travel light into the source where is home. Give all of that to me. You don't need that pain with you anymore. That was a long time ago. Mm-hmm. You ready to release it, Elizabeth? Mm-hmm. Release all of that that you're feeling, all of that anger and all of that pain. For your beloved. Release it and give it to me. When he sees you again, he needs to see you happy. The woman that he loved. Release it all to me. Tell me when I have it all. Done?
Yes.
All right, let's take it and release it to the universe. Now, Elizabeth, in that space, what would you like to fill it with? Lots of love, because that's what you felt for your beloved. Let's seal that. What else would you like to feel?
Happiness.
Happiness. Lots of happiness and joy. You'll be the most happiest spirit in the universe. What else? How about peace? Would you like to feel peace? Let's fill it with peace. So, Elizabeth, I'm asking my band of angels to come around you now. They're waiting for you. I want you to make your way up to her crown, and you're going to be released through the top of her head. Look up into the light, and you'll see it, and the angels will come surround you. Surround you with all of their wings of love and light. feel them around you, Elizabeth, and tell me when they're there.
And as you make your way into the light with the angels, I want you to pull out from
Jackie's body every attachment that you have to her. I want you to pull it from the roots. Take it with you. Pull everything, every bit of anger, every bit of loneliness, all of that pain in her heart.
Pull all of that with you and take it with you. We're going to release that and take it to the light with you so it'll be healed. And I want you to look out for Archangel Michael. He'll be extending his arm out to you. Extend it out to you and take his hand and tell me, Elizabeth, when you've reached the light. You are in the light. Beautiful. So, Elizabeth, from the light, I want you to use that same energy. Beam it down into Jackie's heart, and I want you to mend all of the area where you were residing. You need to heal that for her from the light. Send her all of your love. It's your turn now to be able to send the love that you have inside into her heart so that she can love her, a new beloved, in the way that she needs to. And tell me when she's totally sealed, Elizabeth. Good? Okay. Thank you, Elizabeth. May the light of the universe accompany you. Many blessings to you on your meeting with your beloved in the light. Do you see him? He'll be there waiting for you. Thank you very much. Let me speak with Jackie's higher self again. Thank you. She had questions about her anger and anxiety and her battle with depression. Was that because of Elizabeth?
A lot.
That was a lot of it?
Yes.
Okay, so how does she look now?
Better.
Better. Okay, terrific. Now we're going to seal this, your entire body. I want you to visualize deep within your chest a brilliant point of light. It's your connection with the light, your connection with Source. See this light expand into your whole body. Feel the energy flow through your entire body, down into your legs, out into your arms, filling your head. Imagine now that this light is expanding out past the boundaries of your body, outside your physical form, expanding out about an arm's length in front of you, an arm's length behind you, an arm's length on either side of you, as high as you can reach above your head and down beneath your feet. See and feel this light now, lovingly, protectively, comfortably surrounding you like a large egg-shaped bubble of light. And sparkling through the bubble of light, begin to imagine bits of emerald green. This is the color of the energy of healing. And bits of rose pink, the color of the energy of love. Every cell of your body has its own intelligence and will use this healing energy for the highest good of the entire organism. This cocoon of light does not interfere with the expression of love as you love others, or the expression of love as others love you. Take a moment now and breathe this light in and through every cell of your body. Feel it's healing every cell of your body. like to ask now for Archangel Raphael to come in and complete the work of sealing everything so that the aura is completely intact, so that none of the entities are allowed to come back in. Raise the vibration now with love. Feel the vibration of love vibrating in every cell of your body, because with love, nothing allows these entities to come near you again. Lift your vibration, fill your body with that beautiful love and light. And report back to me, tell me how you feel.
Light,
beautiful. I'd like to thank the higher self today for helping with us today. Is there anything else that you would like to tell Jackie today?
You are love.
You are love, beautiful. Thank you very much. Yeah, I'd like for Jackie to find yourself back into that beautiful surrounding that you love so much, with the mountains, the snow-capped mountains and the river going through, and prepare yourself to come back now. Beginning to wake up now, the happiest woman in the universe, full of love and happiness and very content. Five, wide awake now. Five, wide awake, feeling wonderful all over. Welcome back, my dear.
Hello.
How are you feeling?
Wow.
What do you think? Good?
Yeah. Feel better.
How long do you feel you were on this journey?
It feels like it was forever, and then it also feels like it really wasn't that long at all, if that makes any sense.
What do you think?
An hour?
Try 2 hours.
Oh, okay.
So what do you remember?
I think I remember everything, really. Mm-hmm. I remember, what, four people?
Mm-hmm.
Four people.
Yeah, what about the last one? You had an army, huh?
That was my dark side. That was the dark side. Elizabeth was pretty bad,
mm-hmm.
too. She was pretty crazy.
But this one was connected to many of them.
Yeah.
And we pulled them all. How did that feel?
You could, like, physically feel it, like mm-hmm. a tingly sensation mm-hmm. when it mm-hmm. was, like, trying to come out.
And it was being pulled, he was pulling others, too.
Right, right. You mm-hmm. could feel.
Did you feel like there was a big power struggle going on there? You didn't want to leave, huh?
Like vibrations in my body.
Yeah.
I still feel, like, tingly.
Tingling.
In my
you
hands.
Feel pretty good about it?
Yeah, I feel good.
Pretty intense, huh?
Yeah, definitely.
Good. Is this something that you feel is worthwhile
definitely.
Doing?
Yeah, of course. Yes.
Now, you know we went beyond QHHT, right?
Yeah, for real.
Yeah, we needed some heavy-duty guns there.
That was pretty crazy.
Pretty crazy. Okay, now, I know that this is pretty personal, so I'm sure you don't share this. What do you think?
What did I talk about again? Anything? What did I say?
Past lives are pretty interesting.
But I didn't say nothing bad about this life.
Mm-hmm.
I don't mind.
You don't mind sharing this with others?
No.
So would you recommend this experience to other people?
Yeah, of course. Of course.
So what we did today here is begin with a QHHT session.
I feel happier. Yeah. I just want to smile.
We began with a QHHT session, but once we started finding some entity work here, that now goes beyond the scope of QHHT, and we
right.
did some spirit releasement work on you, some entities that had to go, some forgiveness exercises. So what I call this is the spiritual journey of forgiveness, because It's using...
Had a lot of forgiveness going on.
We had a lot of forgiveness going on.
All that guilt.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
So it was pretty good. You got a lot done today.
Yes.
You can see that a lot of your anger issues and things like that. Wow. Terrific.
Yay.
So, yay. So let me disconnect you.
Do I look like a raccoon? Because I know I've been crying.
Fine. You look beautiful. You look beautiful.
Did I stain anything? Okay.
You're good. You're good. Okay, so let me...
I got super hot at one point.
Yeah, you were burning.
I was like on fire.
Mm-hmm.
Weird.
Yeah. Okay. So, move this over here. I don't know if I have enough light. So, my name is Alba Weinman. We just finished a really nice session here. And if you're interested in your own session, you can go to my website, www.albaweinman.com. And thanks for watching. We'll see each other again soon. Thank you.